And this is time that we discuss Lawrence's popular novels like The Rainbow and its sequel, Women in Love. The Rainbow was published in 1915. I told you, his first novel, The White Peacock, was published in 1911. And The Trespasser was written by him in 1912. And in 1913, he came out with his novel, Sons and Lovers. And it was in 1915, he brought out his novel, The Rainbow. And the theme of the novel is love. And it is considered as a hymn to Eros. Eros is actually the god of love. Cupid is called by the name Eros. And this is considered as a hymn to Eros. A hymn to the god of love. And the novel actually tells the story of three generations of a farming family. And they are called Brangwens. And the family is situated between Nottinghamshire and Derbyshire. And the story actually describes the story from 1840s to 1905. Say the story of about 65 years. From 1840s to 1905. And Tom Brangwen is a member of the Brangwen family. And he gets married with a Polish widow named Lydia. And the widow had a daughter also named Anna. Paul got married with Tom Brangwen got married with Lydia. And she already had a daughter named Anna. And Lydia was a Polish lady. In fact, it seemed very difficult for them to communicate each other. Even though they could not communicate well, they maintained a strong sexual connection. And Anna now grows up. And she marries Tom's nephew, Will. And the same family story continues. Anna gets married with Will. And then the story of the next generation. In the course of years, Anna and Will beget 8 children. And the eldest child is named Ursula. And Ursula is the female protagonist in the novel, The Rainbow. Rainbow actually speaks the story of a farming family for their three generations. In the first generation, we come to find Tom Brangwen getting married with a Polish lady named Lydia. And Lydia has already got a daughter named Anna. And this girl marries Brangwen's nephew named Will. And they are the next generation, Anna and Will. And in the course of years, Anna and Will beget 8 children. And the eldest is called Ursula. And she always dreams of upper class life. And she wants to live in the city. And she liked to explore Christianity. And by the time Ursula falls in love with a young man in the university. And he is also the son of an old family friend. And he is named Anton Skrabinski. Ursula falls in love with Anton. And when Ursula studies in the college, she entertains relation with her lesbian teacher, Miss Inger. And there is also some lesbianism discussed in this novel. Ursula falls in love with a lesbian teacher in the university. And at the same time, she maintains her love with Anton Skrabinski. And after all completing her graduation, she accepts a teaching post in the neighborhood school and continues to work there for 2 years. Then she again returns to the college. And her father, Will, has now become an instructor of art handicraft. and the family attained some higher social position. Ursula actually wanted to lead an upper class life in the city. And by now her father has become an instructor of arts and handicrafts. And the family attains a higher social position. And as she has been in the college, she spends her time with her lover Anton Shrubsky. And the two of them go for a tour also. And during the tour, they consummate their love. And Ursula fails in the exam. And she is about to engage with Anton Shrubsky. And the family is prepared to make a marriage between Ursula and Anton Shrubsky. But Ursula now doesn't want to be married. She feels that she will lose her freedom by marrying Anton Shrubsky. She has spent her time with Anton Shrubsky and they consummated their love and they made picnics also. But when it came to be the question of marrying, she refused him, saying that she would lose her freedom. And Anton Shrubsky left Ursula and went to India to take up some job in India in the East India Company. And when Anton Shrubsky is found leaving England, Ursula realizes that she is pregnant. Only then she comes to understand that she is pregnant. And she writes letters to Anton, but Anton doesn't reply because she formerly rejected him, so he didn't send a reply. Fortunately, she miscarries. And she also learns that Anton has become engaged. And when she miscarries, she feels herself relieved of the burden of the pregnancy. And actually, she comes to find a rainbow towering over the earth, promising a new dawn for humanity. And she feels independence and decides to start life afresh. And she is not worried about her love with Anton Shrubsky. And when she comes to learn that Anton has plans to marry another lady, so she felt that she was relieved. And when she miscarried, she felt greatly relieved. And she found a rainbow in the sky offering her promise of a new dawn. And she feels that she is now independent. And she decides to start life afresh. And this is the content of the novel, The Rainbow, produced by Lawrence in 1915, speaking about three generations of a farming family called the Brangwens. Tom Brangwen marrying Lydia, and Lydia is a lady with a daughter also named Anna in her relation with her first husband. And Anna gets married with Will, and Will was a nephew of Tom Brangwen. And in the course of years, Anna and Will had 8 children. And the story of the rainbow is actually concentrated on the story of the elder daughter Ursula. So in the novel, written as the sequel to Rainbow, we again come to find Ursula. So the story of Ursula is continued in the sequel entitled Women in Love. And we come to find that there are 2 women. Not only Ursula, but her sister Gudrun also. And it is the story of these 2 ladies. And we can say Gudrun is the protagonist here. In the second novel, Women in Love, Gudrun, the sister of Ursula, is more prominent. And Women in Love was produced by him in 1920. Rainbow was produced by him in 1915. And Women in Love was produced by him in 1920. And it was a sequel to The Rainbow. And it continues the love affair of the Brangwen sisters. And they are Gudrun and Ursula. The story of Ursula we have already heard in the novel The Rainbow, and again the story of Ursula is produced in The Women in Love. Not only the story of Ursula, but the story of her sister Gudrun is also described here. Ursula has become a teacher now, and her sister is an artist. Gudrun is an artist and Ursula is a teacher. And they meet two men who live nearby. One was a school inspector named Rupert Birkin. And Ursula fell in love with Rupert Birkin. He was a school inspector. And through him, they came into friendship with Gerald Critch. And Gudrun fell in love with Gerald Critch. And Gerald Critch was a heir to a coal miner. He was a rich young man. And they owned a coal mining company. And the couple became very friendly, discussing questions of society. Ursula and Rupert Birkin, and Gudrun and Gerald Critch. And they are the couples. And they became very friendly. They discussed questions of society, politics, relationship between men and women. And Gudrun, while attending a party at Gerald's house, Gerald Critch was in love with Gudrun. And he invited Gudrun also to attend a party held in his estate. So during the party, Gerald's sister, named Diana, became drowned to death. And when she was drowned to death, a doctor attending the party jumped into the water to save her. And the doctor was named Brindle, but he also became dead. And after the death of Diana, Gudrun became the teacher and mentor of Gerald's younger sister. The younger sister became very sorrowful. The younger sibling of Gerald Critch, named Winifred Critch. She became lonely and Gudrun wanted to assist her. And Gudrun was an artist and she drew pictures. And she drew the picture of her dog Lulu. And it was one question asked by UGC once. The name of the dog of Winifred Critch. So I told you, Gudrun fell in love with Gerald Critch and Critch invited her to attend a party. And during the party, his sister Diana became drowned to death. And the other sister, named Winifred Critch, became very unhappy and lonely. In fact, to relieve her loneliness, Gudrun started attending the house regularly. And she served as a governess to the girl. And Gudrun, being an artist, produced many pictures and drew the picture of Winifred Critch's dog named Lulu, L-O-O-L-O-O. And it was at the time Critch's father, Gerald Critch's father, died. And after the funeral of the father, Gerald spent a night with Gudrun, unknowing to her parents. And Gerald visited the house of Gudrun and stayed with Gudrun and consummated their love. Birkin asks Ursula to marry him, and Rupert Birkin and Ursula were in love and there were no problems. And Birkin wanted Ursula to marry him and they agreed to marry. And Gerald and Gudrun's love became stormy. In the case of the love between Ursula and Rupert Birkin, there were no problems. They decided to marry. But in the case of Gerald and Gudrun's love, there were problems. The love became stormy. And the two couple, Rupert Birkin and Ursula, Gerald Critch and Gudrun, and these two couples, they went for a holiday in the Alps mountains. And while staying in the lodging near the Alps mountains, Gudrun developed an intense friendship with a sculptor named D.H.Lawrence. There was a young sculptor named D.H.Lawrence. And he was a physically puny man, but emotionally he was a commanding artist. And Gudrun was also an artist. In fact, while visiting Alps, she developed a friendship with a young painter and sculptor named Leorg. And Gerald became enraged on finding... Gerald was angry to find the friendship between Gudrun and Leorg. And Gudrun was found spending her time with the sculptor named Herr Leorg. And Gerald became angry. He tried to strangle Gudrun. So he wanted to kill Gudrun. And as he was about to strangle her, suddenly he realized that this was actually not required for him. He understood that this was not what he wanted. So killing the lady was not at all necessary for him. He was not anyhow entitled to kill Gudrun. So he left Gudrun and climbed up the mountain. And it was at the time there was the snow falling. And he fell into a snowy valley and he fell asleep and he freezed to death. The next morning, Gerald Critch was found dead. And the impact of Gerald's death on Birkin is very profound. And the novel comes to conclude with Birkin saying to Ursula that he needed Gerald as much as he needed Ursula. So actually, through the friendship of Rupert Birkin, Gerald Critch became a friend to the family and fell in love with Gudrun. And after all, when Gudrun showed interest in another painter and sculptor named Leorg, he became angry and tried to strangle Gudrun, but left the idea and went up to the mountain and fell into a snowy valley and became dead. So the death of Gerald actually had a great impact on Rupert Birkin. And Gerald was a very close friend of Rupert Birkin. And now he comes to say to Ursula that he needed Gerald as much as he needed the love of Ursula. And these two novels are written as sequels. Rainbow is followed by The Women in Love. Rainbow was produced by D.H. Lawrence in 1915 and Women in Love was produced by him in 1920.